Hi everyone, I'm Anshumani and this was a part of my master's degree project. So it's about experiencing Ajanta caves. So the caves look like this. It's at the bend of a river and you start from here and you go right up till here. So there are 26 Buddhist caves, all hand painted by monks, and most of them are still preserved. Some of them has worn out, but yeah, so this is the site, and I want to design, I mean my project was to redesign the experience, leveraging on the advantages of IT and providing some basic infrastructure support. So my basic idea is that to make any service or experience better, the services need to be provided for them, and only then maybe you could improve the experience little more. So this is the site. So what happens is that a person starts here. You go on a bus. You're not allowed to go by your own vehicles. You go on the service bus provided by the site and you climb right up till here. And here you buy another ticket and you buy your ticket and everything, and you can either hire a porter, because you really need to climb up this hill. It's about 90 steps, but yeah, it's kind of steep. Or you can hire a porter and you climb up, and this is the whole line of caves. And this is the river. So in this service system, there is a water drinking point here. There is another water drinking point down here, and there is only one common toilet. Or else you will have to go down here again and go to toilet here. Plus, there is no, you cannot use your cell phones here. There is no signal. There is no, I mean, you cannot catch any, call anybody if you need also. Plus, it's a very delicate monument in a sense that the paints used here are vegetative paints. So the monks used to make the paints out of flowers and leaves and everything. So if you do flash photography, it affects the paintings. You cannot take photographs with flash. And so this is, and it's a, and it's pretty much almost 2 kilometers from here to here. So it's quite tiring also. And so before reaching the caves, a person would need to come until Aurangabad, which is the nearest town in surrounding the Ajanta caves. Then they'll have to book the tickets at the foothills. They'll have to take a bus ride from the foothills to the caves. At the caves, you have an entrance line. You have a very big line, because it's just one small door, and then you have to go inside. And people tend to rest more at the cave number one. So what happens there is that, because lots of travelers are coming and climbing all these steps, their bodies are already heated. So once they sit inside the caves, the relative humidity affects the paintings, and the paintings start to flake off. So, and also then they have to do a 2 kilometer thing, visit to each cave. Before entering every cave, you have to take off your footwear, because it affects, the dust particles affect the paintings again. And there is a cave attendant at every cave who's looking after, you know, everybody and monitoring everyone in their way in and way out. And after leaving the caves, you take a return bus journey till the foothills. You go back to wherever you were, maybe your city, your hometown, and then you have a recall of the experience. You look at your photographs, you talk about the journey, you talk to other visitors who have been to the caves before, and this is the existing current scenario at the site. So the amenities, basic amenities, are that there is a shopping plaza. There are some signage boards which tells you about the location, about the basic journey. There are porter services, and there is a Ajanta visitor center. So it's a tourism project. So it's at the foothills, like where I had shown you before. It's right here next to the bus shuttle service before you actually start the journey. And here there are some, it's mostly designed like a museum, where you have infographic panels, you have the whole timeline, you have maps, you have your narrative movies, etc. And they have certain cave replicas. So what they have done is that they have photographed the cave paintings, and they have created flex paintings, replicas, and post, I mean, it's like you can take your picture there, you can do whatever flash photography you want to do, so that you don't actually go and do it there, okay, up in the real cave. So What I did here was that I redesigned the system, taking into account that I want all these players to work together, like the Archaeological Survey of India, who looks after archaeological sites, the local street transport who runs the bus services, plus the people who actually maintain the place. I want them to work together in a system where the front end is the visitor's end, and the back end is how the people working for the case will be maintaining it. So before reaching the site, the visitor logs on to this platform. So I looked after the platform and the interactive devices that the person would be handling at the front end. And at the back end, it is all linked. So before the visitor reaches the caves, you get information on the service. The tourists can look up information, they can pre-book their services, they can book seats for the lightning sound show. Plus, at the back end, what happens is that the moment visitors do this, the people maintaining the site get an idea about how many visitors to at least expect, what kind of a crowd they are going to deal with, and plus, they can be monitored in a better way. Plus, during the visit, the bus ride is a point where I think it takes almost 10 minutes on the bus from the foothills till the caves. So it's almost a point where a visitor can be briefed about what they are going to see. And it's almost like a point where people can be pre-informed and, you know, set correct expectations about what to expect there. And the the porter services plus the bus shuttle services, they can run much more smoothly. Plus, after completion of the project, the content that you are generating out here is saved. So the visitor can take that content and do whatever, share or show or store it for further recall or for their experience. Plus, the website enlists they have the content, they have 3 months worth of visitor content which they can work on and study and see patterns and, you know, maybe improve the whole system further. So the stakeholders are basically the visitors in the front, plus I'm calling my system Explore Ajanta here, and the visitors center, the ticket counter people and the shopping complex all work together to make the basic management and transport accommodation services for the back-end people. So while doing this, what happens is that, so once you maybe book your ticket to Ajanta Caves, or you are in the city where Ajanta Caves is actually situated, it's called Aurangabad. So you get posters or you get your railway tickets, which gives a link to you to your site, to the website. And which also, both of these are basically triggers or clues that the people can cling on to when they want to visit the site. So once the visitor lands on the website, it works like this. So you get a history, you get how to reach, you get information, information, or you can download the app, but it's not necessary. Plus you get the idea of whatever services are there. So services like, there was this thing that when you look at paintings, you do not need a visual clue. You do not need any more visuals than what's already there. So there was a, there is a concept of a hand device, so it's just a belt and a Bluetooth headphone which just tells you what the painting is about, and your location is transmitted so you know what it is. And also for people who would like a visual device, they have a visual device, or you can actually book a tourist guide here so that he can tell you what it is and what the whole painting is about. Then there are services like the lightning sound show. So at present there is no one consolidated place where they would tell you what the whole place is about, or maybe give a brief history of the place. So this was one point I thought I could engage visitors in, where the whole experience would be completely different in the night. Plus it would be great to leverage on something like this. And so once you're registered, what happens is that you get to see your bookings, you get to see what all devices you have at hand, and you get to see what all services you have booked. Plus, Ajanta today is like a live feed. It's like a live feed from the caves itself. So in India, I'm not sure about the other places, but vandalism is a big problem that we deal with when it comes to historical monuments. So people like to scribble their names on monuments or write stuff. So we thought, why not, you know, if you want such, I mean, we look at it as a kind of self-expression. So if you want some kind of a self-expression at this level, we provided footprints at Ajanta so that you can leave some kind of a footprint behind and not actually write anything on the monument. And if you look at it, you can even write a tag maybe, like you love the paintings or something. And this was an emo trail that we looked at. Like, in each cave, what have people emoted as? You know, you feel happy, you feel sad, you feel secluded, you feel blessed. Whatever you feel, you can emote on the emo trail. So, and it's a live feed. It's for anyone who enters this site. You can see what all today people are feeling at what cave. It's a live data generation. Plus, we have a visitors forum so that people who want to blog about it, it's like one go-to spot and you can write your data. And so basically what happens is that once you register on this site, you have an artifact with you. It's on your phone and you always have an option of downloading the app, but you don't need to if you don't want to. And here it tells you what all, where, and the dates you have booked for and what services. And this is one day before the visit. It's like a reminder that you have been booked and you can visit the site. And at the present time you have to buy tickets thrice. So this was just a collaboration of tickets to be sold at one place and not making the visitor pay again and again. And so once they are on the journey, visitors can visit the site with their hands-free devices or with their interactive video devices. And if the visitor decides to download the app, you get your interactive own devices, but if you want to download your own app, so the app works like this. It tells you what happens is that because it's a 2 kilometer long stretch, people sometimes tend to miss out things at the end because you are tired and you feel like, you know, it's almost a repetition and let me go back. So it tells you the major sites that you should not miss. It tells you that please go there and see it. And it also tells you facilities, because it's very important for people to know what facilities are where. Plus, because of the shortage of toilets, they should be really working on. The other facilities like food and everything is also like very far off. You have to really, I had to pack my own sandwiches because there was no food stall. So your trail is recorded onto the device, the way you move around. And you can mark your footprint through the app. You can write, you can put an update, you can emote, and you can sync your camera onto this app so that your photographs are automatically in your profile. You don't need to sync them again to share it on or show it to anybody else. So apart from that, we thought that because there were two resting points, major resting points, one being near one water cooler and next one being near the next water cooler. So we thought some kind of an interactive device would help, because a lot of crowd is gathered there. We need to disperse that crowd from there so that they don't block that one passage which is there. So here a thing like you can paint your own Ajanta painting. You select from a range of 10 paintings that we have captured and we have been able to digitize for now, and kids can explore it here. And the other facilities are like the same that I had shown you on the app. So it works like this. So kids can maybe adults can work on it. And so after the visit, the visitor can actually see your trail. You can download your trail, how you walked and where you went, and maybe with your captions like this, you can download your entire trail from, and you can look for other people's footprints if you want to look for like your friends if they have visited with you. Plus, if you want to see the footprints on a particular day on Ajanta, plus if you want to tag yourself and share your web link somewhere, you can do that from here. And your emote trail, it's the same. So we did some kind of basic first level testing with the whole system. So here we wanted actually multilingual options of the app, because we just created this in English, and major population who actually comes to see the place is Hindi speaking or native language. So we thought multilingual options would be better. People could not understand the concept of an emo trail in the beginning, but slowly maybe they will catch on, we are hoping. But we'll have to run more tests with this. And so there is a concept of if I want to get lost, I'm not a traditional traveler, I don't need a map, I just want to get lost in the caves, how do I do that? How does my system allow that? That is still something we are looking forward to. And social media links is something that we need to provide with this, heavily demanded from the testers. Yeah. And so the further development plan is that my school that I go to, they have been contacted by the government of India, so they're taking up this project now. And this is like the first cut that I'm showing you, but we are further working on it, and we are trying to develop it into a more holistic system. And yeah, that's about it. Thank you so much.